I'm ready whenever you want.
Hi everyone, we're the team from FedEx and we're going to be presenting our e-commerce problem identification. I'm Bridget.
I'm Oriana.
I'm Steven.
I'm Nick.
And I'm Josh. So today we're going to be touching on e-commerce, the supply chain, operations, applications, and our competitors. Okay. So today I was walking on campus and I saw every student have their head in a laptop, cell phone, or tablet. And retailers see this and they're going to this as a form of selling their product to customers. Instead of brick and mortar stores, they're looking more into internet and website bases to get their product out to customers in a more convenient way. Who here has ever shopped on Black Friday? Well, you guys are a lot braver than me because I'm not trying to get stabbed over a PlayStation 3 or a toaster. Turns out I'm allergic to death, so I decided to wait until Cyber Monday and buy off the internet from the safety of my own house on my couch. And other Americans, and worldwide actually, find this as a better way to get their shopping done in the holiday season. And how does this affect us? Well, retailers need a way to get their packages from the warehouse to the customers, so they use our courier services to get this done. Our e-commerce market is predicted to grow 30% each year until 2018. So what's the downside of this? Well, as you guys know, email and fax has grown exponentially since when we were founded in 1971. So customers and companies do not look to us anymore to deliver packages across town. They can just email someone or tweet someone and get it done that way.
I'll be discussing the supply chain, and really what supply chain focuses on is how to get from point A to point B. So we'll be looking at the different modes of transportation, from airplanes to trains to even cars. And we will also be discussing the priority shipping, the one-day, the two-day shipping, and how that can be achieved. And really, the last thing will be the backbone of all operations is FedEx's tracking system. So the delivery system for FedEx, the main thing is you can pick up, or FedEx will either pick up a package or at the package drop-off center. And these packages can be different shapes and sizes. FedEx accommodates for all of these. And once it's there, it's put to a processing plant where they put in multiple labels that allows it to track easily. And from there, it's transported to a facility closest to its destination, sorted and delivered to your house. And this can all be tracked using the Cosmos, which is an online operating monitoring system that tracks packages for FedEx. This has been in use since the 1970s for FedEx. However, in the early 2000s, they allowed it to open up to the customers, which really provided the customers a much more reliable timing system customer experience to know where their packages are exactly. Some of the recent technological improvements that goes along with this is now they have smartphones and devices in the cars, which really allow it to track exact locations. It will tell you approximately what time it will be delivered. It will tell you if it's in the car, if it's in transit. And so these really impact the e-commerce. E-commerce has three main sources. It's used with FedEx Express, FedEx Ground, and FedEx Freight. FedEx Express is the most used. It's for mainly priority and one-day and two-day shipping. This is used by mostly small businesses. And this is the use of airplanes and other services. FedEx Ground is the use of cars, and FedEx Freight is the use of trains.
So, operational costs are a major factor in FedEx profit margins, specifically transportation costs. FedEx, a lot of people don't think of them like this, but they are an airline, and like any airline, they make money when all their seats are filled. If you have an empty seat, it's still the same price as getting from point A to point B, so you'd like to have a fuel-efficient plane that's full. And the problem FedEx ran into is dimensional-based pricing. When FedEx charges you for a package, they weigh that package, depending on how heavy it is, that's how much they're going to charge you. But they ran into an issue with very large packages that didn't weigh very much, like a giant plastic container or something. It takes up a lot of room on the plane, but it doesn't cost that much to ship. So they found that planes were full of large packages that didn't weigh very much, and they had to adjust the pricing where last year in 2015, they changed it to where it's going to be a 30 to 50% increase on dimensional-based pricing, which helps out the margins a lot. The issue with FedEx operating costs is it's similar to a vicious cycle, and e-commerce is not necessarily FedEx's strong suit, hence our whole presentation is about e-commerce, but they need to spend a lot of money on e-commerce to keep up with the competition, and when you do that, you're hiking up your operation costs very high. FedEx likes to believe they can ship anything. They ship pandas from China to Toronto, and that's a good ability to have that they can say they can do that, but to keep up with their competitors, they've been spending a lot of money, and they haven't gained a whole lot of ground. They've had a 4% increase in global spending, and it related to a 1% increase in global exports. So FedEx needs to decide how much to spend to keep up with the competitors on e-commerce without hiking up operational costs too much.
So when it comes to e-commerce, app also play a crucial part for FedEx. This customer can use apps to keep track and take control of their package through any service devices at any time. And FedEx currently have two different apps. That one, the print one, is for FedEx Office, and this one is for FedEx Delivery. And these two apps almost cover most of the services that you can think of. However, we still come up with some problems that FedEx can be improved of. First of all, the FedEx Delivery app still won't available for the Android system, so which makes the customer who have Android system harder to get access to their service. And also we think that it's much more easier for customer to combine the two apps together, so customer can just only download one app and access their whole service. And also we think in order to make e-commerce supply chain much more fluently, we think that FedEx can add the new pickup service, which means customer can just look up app and know which FedEx car will pass by their companies and the home, so they can just directly pick up the package for them. And since e-commerce is an international business, so we think it is more necessary for FedEx to make the international package service as the ground shipping service.
So e-commerce is a huge factor for FedEx in terms of being able to differentiate itself from its competitors. UPS is FedEx's biggest competition. UPS has 38.9% of the market share, while FedEx has 30.5%. So clearly these two competitors dominate the marketplace in terms of the private delivery service industry, but the public delivery service industry can't be overlooked. In 2015 alone, the U.S. Postal Service experienced a 15% growth in package volume, and they're also developing their technology as well. Recently, they've been testing in New York City a mail notification system, so customers can get an email on their phone about what's expected to be delivered that day and the time of the delivery. Moving forward, Amazon is going to become an even bigger competitor than they already are. Amazon already has 25% of a French shipping company, Colis Privé, and they're expected to acquire the other 75% in 2016. And they're also in negotiations of leasing a fleet of 20 Boeing 767 aircrafts. So with these two acquisitions, they're no longer going to be relying on outside companies like FedEx to deliver their shipments. So because of Amazon's growth and the technological advances of the other competitors, FedEx must invest heavily in e-commerce in order to compete in this changing industry. And with that, we'd like to thank you all for your time and open up the floor to any questions that you may have.
Okay. So the issue, I'm trying to wrap my head around this because I'm not sure that I fully understand. The issue is e-commerce, and more specifically, it's the app environment. Is that right?
I think we are mostly focused on the lack thereof of e-commerce.
Okay.
They do have an app, they do have tracking devices and everything,
right,
but it's not as advanced as, say, Amazon's or UPS's or even the Postal Service. And so it's basically just to grow their entire e-commerce segment of that supply chain.
Okay. That's a huge undertaking. And that's whether you're communicating about it or actually proposing the actual strategy, you have about 6 or 7 weeks for this project. So I'd encourage you to try to narrow that down as much as you can and really focus on one specific aspect of e-commerce that you can that you can really focus on. So I agree with you. I have the FedEx app on my phone. It's terrible. It never works. I can't log in. It doesn't stay logged in. It's awful. So I think you're right. I think there's a big opportunity there. But the more specific you can be, I think the happier you're going to be over the next 6 or 7 weeks. Okay. Somebody else have any questions? Okay. We're going to leave it there.